Alright guys, I'm going to walk you through how I fit up and tack water tanks, diesel tanks, just tanks in general. This one in particular is going to be a 40 gallon grey water tank for one of our food trucks. 1/8 inch diamond plate. So, it's what works for me, not necessarily the way everyone does it, but what works for me. When I'm tacking up an aluminum tank like this, my tacks are just fuse welds. That way when you go back over with the weld, you don't have a big old bubble, a big old bump everywhere over every one of your tacks. You know, fusing the aluminum, it's not structural, but it's enough to hold it in place while you're putting tacking the tank together to get your initial shape. So I run open corner joints on these, run my tacks every 5 or 6 inches, give or take. Running the open corner really lets you burn the rod in, make sure you got as much penetration as you need without burning through into the inside of the tank. 9 times out of 10, that lets you know, it ensures that you're not going to have a leak by the time you're done. That's pretty much how I run them. I got the baffle in there, which stops the water or whatever fluid you have in your tank sloshing around. I'm gonna stitch it in place. We got the tank all sealed up. Now we're gonna put the coupling in. Diamond plate comes pretty clean, so I don't really need to do anything apart from give it a quick brush down with a wire brush or wire wheel. Couplings or fittings are always super greasy, so a little bit of brake cleaner or acetone. Don't have to use a fancy microfiber towel. Just what I got. You can use any old rag that's laying around. Give them a clean. Just like when I tack the tank, like every 5-6 inches, tack the coupling, you know, in 4 places, so as you're welding it, it doesn't shift. That way you've got it square, it stays square while you're welding it out. All right, folks, that's it. Tank's all welded up, coupling's in place. Now we're gonna pressure test it. We're gonna do our water tanks at 7 psi. The water tanks and fuel tanks 7 psi. Pretty low, but seems to be the standard. So it's all done, good to go. Later.